All right, guys, today we are going to have some fun with the new Aero pouch from the Pocket Shot. Now, I know you guys remember about a year ago, I did the Pocket Shot video 2.0 with the Whisker Biscuit attachment as a new design feature and a new accessory they had for the Pocket Shot. And I was really excited about that. However, based off this that video I did a year ago, some R&D they've already been working on, and a couple other channels, like the Slingshot channel from York's Brav, they decided to go ahead and, hey, let's make a huge Aero pouch. Now, as you guys can see, it's a lot bigger. And what it'll do is allow you to get an entire full draw length, which we are going to show you guys that here in a minute. But they were actually kind enough to send me a few test arrows. And I'm at my friend's house over here. And we actually have a nice little target to hit this time, instead of me having to go off in the woods and hit a rack of ribs that pretty much pissed off everybody. So we're going to have some fun. Now, with the arrow, part of the arrow cap kit that the Pocket Shot provides you, not only do you get a Whisker Biscuit, but they also send these little nubs. Now, these nubs, these little nibs, are designed to go over the nock. So it'll look like this. Because when it's in the pouch and it sinks in, it pokes. And see the little double prong? That'll end up damaging your pouch. But when you pop it in this way, you have just one singular piece sticking out and you're good to go. So that was pretty ingenious on their end, and it doesn't come out when released through the Whisker Biscuit. It works just fine. It's perfectly sized. So that is the reason for that, if you guys were wondering. So I have an extra spare pouch just in case it breaks, but my experience with the Pocket Shot is their pouches are actually extremely durable. So we have the big one. We're going to put the Whisker Biscuit attachment on, and I'm going to show you how easy it is. Literally take the cap off. We'll cut right into this live for you guys. And it simply pops right on. Nothing to it. Take it. Good to go. That looks kind of weird. All right, so we're gonna stick some arrows to it and have some fun. One thing I wanted to make mention, as I was really curious about, is due to the fact that I did use this last year in an arrow pouch, I want to take these head-to-head and see how they're fair against each other. That'd be kind of a cool comparison, since I do have both Pocket Shots available. And also, one final thing I think will be pretty awesome is, due to the fact that you can take the steel ball ammunition into the normal Pocket Shot, I can't see any reason why not that we can't try to see if we get a longer draw length, some more power, and actually punch some serious holes into some empty paint cans, which is a little bit thicker walls compared to my Arizona tea. So we're gonna have a little bit of fun, do some target shooting, and let's not waste any more time because I'm really excited and I wanna get the shooting. Okay, now the three arrows I'll be shooting today are two aluminum full length arrows that the Pocket Shot did send me. And I have a junior arrow to see how that fares and if I can get a little more speed out of it. But due to the fact that the pouch is much, much longer on the Pocket Shot, I think it might either be too long, not be long enough, the arrow might not be long enough, or I don't know. So it'll be a fun experiment, so that's what we're going to try. It's pretty simple to load an arrow into the Pocket Shot. We've got the Whisker Biscuit. Stick it right in. Now, this arrow pouch actually gives you a really good draw length. If you guys can see, I can get almost a full draw length without even really trying too hard. Guys can tell the Pocket Shot is a lot different from the arrow pouch that they provide. So I want to see the difference that I was fighting with last year. Not even half as close. So if we so I'm about 10 yards away. We're gonna take aim at the pouch. I'm gonna use the pro pouch first to show you what I was dealing with last year. It just took a little practice. And there is some definite noticeable pull. But I am still off to the right a little bit, but it's getting a little better. So that's with the Pro Pouch. That's not with the arrow pouch. So we're going to go swap to the arrow pouch, retrieve the arrows, and then we can see the difference of power. Because right now, I'm not mad at this. This little thing being in the palm of my hand is not upsetting me right now. So let's see what happens when I can get a much, much longer draw length. So here's the arrow. Didn't go very far in. There's not a lot of power. It's pretty quick, but there's not a lot of impacting strength that comes with the Pro Pouch, because I don't only get a draw length to about here, and there's still this much sticking out. But with the Pro Pouch, with the arrow pouch, I can go really, really, really far in and get almost the entire length of a full-length arrow. So that is the hope, that we get a lot more power, and this could actually turn into a very real viable hunting option in an absolute emergency. Will this replace your bow or crossbow or your compound bow, stuff like that? Absolutely not. But an absolute emergency as a extreme backup tool, and your bowstrings break and you just have to be able to go hunting and kill something, this is what I'm here to test today. So just to be clear. All right, guys, so now I've got the arrow pouch. As you can see, that's without me really trying to get a full draw length. I'm able to get a full draw length pretty easy. So we're gonna take out the target and see what improvements we can get with arrow pouch. Holy shit. Wow, that was a lot better. Yes. Thank you. This arrow pouch is awesome. Still at 10 yards. I missed. Ow, that actually nicked me a little bit. Oh well. But yeah, so let's go come forward a little bit, and we're gonna go check out the penetration from these arrows. I'm actually pretty excited. So again, this is with the arrow pouch this time. Oh yeah, you see that? That extra draw length made all the difference. And these aren't broadheads, these aren't professional arrows. I felt a much bigger kick and let off with the arrow, and it went almost all the way to the other side of the bag. That's pretty freaking awesome. And this training tip doesn't even have a sharp tip on it, and it sent it a good 3.5 inches into the bag. So that's awesome. So let's keep doing some more shooting, because this is absolutely a lot of fun. We're gonna go back at it at 10 yards with the arrow pouch. Oh, I don't like missing. Told you guys, I am not Robin Hood. Far, 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 far from it. I am a novice in every sense of the word. And if it was my first time hunting and we were starving for 3 days, I'd probably get everybody in my group killed, because I am not a professional. However, at 10 yards away, it's completely possible. So maybe I'll up the ante and try to go to 15, but that's a big risk, but I'll try it anyway. So we're gonna go retrieve the arrows, and I'm gonna push the target back just a little bit farther. All right, so my lovely camera lady wants to try the arrow pouch, and she wants to see how easy it is for an average strength, average size woman. She is 5'3", 126 pounds. Yep, I know we're not supposed to do that on camera, and you're not supposed to tell a woman's weight, but that's what she is. So she's at 10 yards, and we're gonna go back, and she's gonna have some fun shooting. Nice shot. You guys can tell she grew up in the small towns. She's not a city boy like me. So, how you liking it?
Pretty good. It's actually a lot easier than an actual bow and arrow.
It's noticeably less power, but
yeah.
It works. It's effective.
Pretty accurate, too.
Yeah, we're going to go retrieve some arrows. We're going to push that bag all the way back out to 15 yards. And then we're going to do some target practice with some steel ball ammo. Okay, guys, we are back here. I'm at about 15 yards, which is pretty much the full length of the backyard, with a couple feet exception. But I don't want to get too close to the neighbor's house. That's why we're shooting nice and low. There's a two-step backyard. It's a little safer for me to able aim down. So if I miss, I'd hit the wall, damage the arrows, or it goes into the ground. Wow, so it's really fast, but I'm not accurate. But I was pretty close, I was just off to the left. But I'm not really mad at myself, considering I am not an archer. Naturally, this is... Whoa. I got comfortable with 10. All right, let's try this one more time. Come on, give me one. There we go. 15 yards. I'm happy with that. So let's go see the penetration difference we get at 15 yards versus 10. So I got one arrow. I'm not mad. One out of three for a guy who doesn't know what he's doing. That's not bad. I know this is a target. This is just that tarp material filled basically with some type of foam to not let the arrows go through. But like I said, I've kind of blunted the tips on these because I'm hitting this rock. I feel really bad. I'm doing more damage to these arrow tips. But still, 5.5, almost 6 inches of penetration at 15 yards with someone who doesn't know what they're doing. I like it. I am much happier with the arrow pouch than I was with the pocket shot, and I was not displeased in any fashion with the pocket shot. So we're going to do, I'm feeling froggy. I'm going to do three more shots at 15 yards, and then we're going to go and get the Stoball ammo. So I changed my mind. I decided to go back to the Pro Pouch. Since I did feel like doing a comparison, I'm going to take the Pro Pouch and try to go out to 15 yards with this and see the, I'm sure I'm going to have a noticeable power loss as far as the speed and the impact, even if I even hit it. At 10 yards, this isn't super horrible, but see, I mean, I can't get a full draw length, so it's hard to control. Instead of kind of like pushing and being able to allow the arrow to go all the way through and kind of even itself out before it shoots the whisker biscuit, it was making the arrow go off like psychotically cockeyed. It's not that crazy paradox they talk about. It's really wobbly. And it could be me too, shaking my hand, being a little shaky with it, but I am noticing a distinct power loss. I mean, I'm surprisingly more accurate with this thing, I guess. But it's not impacting as deep. It's not really going to be where I can hit the vital organs, I don't think. And I don't know if it'll be able to punch through. Maybe with the broadhead, it might be a different story because it'd be able to cut and slice instead of just a kind of a slightly sharpened blunt tip. But we'll go and see the impact of this. Then I'll switch back to the arrow pouch as promised. Like I said, guys, this is a lot of fun. And even if you just do this for giggles in the backyard, yeah, see? The Pro Pouch, the difference in impact was just astoundingly different. It literally only 1.5, 2 inches versus the 6 inches I got with the arrow pouch. So the arrow pouch is thicker. It's a lot longer. I know there's that comment in the section. I'll be like, oh, that's what she said. But this is quite a fun weekend I'm having. This is 4th of July, actually, that I'm filming this on. Instead of getting drunk, I'm making videos for you guys. Good shot. And go back to the arrow pouch at 15 yards. And we're going to have some fun. Let's pray I actually hit some. I want to go out on a good note. Otherwise, you guys are going to have to suffer through some more shots. Holy, I'm just swallowing this junior arrow up. Woo! Yeah, the power and impact you're getting off of the arrow pouch is just ridiculous. Oh, I'm happy right now. This is bringing me so much joy. Honestly, guys, I want to thank the Pocket Shot for sending this out to me. This is so much fun. So let's go check out one more time the impact, the difference. Now, I feel so much more oomph on the release, and you can hear the very palpable smack from this. But yeah, see the difference on that? That is just, this will actually help you get to the lungs, the heart, the vital organs if you're using it as an emergency hunting tool, whether it's hogs, deer, coyotes maybe, foxes, I don't know. I think this might be, the arrow pouch might be a little too much overkill. It's about 4.5, 5. But like I said, if someone's a little stronger than me, I might get to have some more luck. But I am having a lot of fun target practicing and testing out this arrow pouch. It is an absolute freaking joy. Okay, now we have taken the whisker biscuits out. I'm sticking with the Pro Pouch. I like the Pro Pouch the best. It gives me a lot of power, but we're gonna be shooting 3/8 inch diameter steel balls, and we're gonna be shooting 5/16 out of the new arrow pouch from the Pocket Shot. And also using the Pro Pouch again to see the power. Now over here, I have some targets. Now these are only maybe 5-6 yards away. I'm not that good. But I have them lined in red. That's my my target. I'm trying to think small, aim small, miss small, hopefully, maybe. So we'll see how that works. But yeah, this is all about having fun. So let's get the shooting. I'm painstakingly gonna have to go through and pick up all these steel balls, which will be one hell of a FOD walk. For anybody who's in the military, you know what a FOD walk is. Wow, that was kind of awesome. I wish I could have actually said that happened on purpose. So that ball I just shot actually bounced up, hit the fence, and came back and landed on the pile that I have the ammo set in. Like, hey, shoot me again, I can do this. That was kind of awesome. I was a little scared because I thought it was going to hit me. There we go, now I'm hitting something. Okay, so let's go and bring it out now that I finally hit something. Not bad. It, whoa. So if you guys can see the carnage, it barreled through that, no problem. But these are like soda cans equivalent. So what I really want to hit is this due to the fact that it's a lot thicker. And I think I'm gonna save that for the aero pouch. All right, so we have switched now officially to the aero pouch. I am terrified for this thing because this thing has mad power. Oh my God. Holy crap. Oh, that was amazing. Okay, so I'm pretty proud of myself. I made these little paint lines, and I actually hit the paint line. So yay for that. First shot, too. Really excited. It actually hit and bounced off. These cans are a lot more... they're a lot more hardy. So I'll do, I don't think I'm going to get the same explosive excitement that I did last time, but I'm going to aim for that can one more time and see if we get lucky. I am going to say this is, should be almost maybe called the Pro Pouch Extreme. I know why they call the arrow pouches specifically for arrows, but this thing is amazing. This Pro Pouch, I think, the arrow pouch, I mean, I think would be epic for paintballs. All right, so at the risk of hitting my friend's house, who was so gracious to let me shoot out here in his backyard, because as you guys know, I live in an apartment, that'll do it. So two things we can take from this. One, I'm a really, really bad shot. And three, using for arrows and shooting, the arrow pouch is absolutely outstanding. I could not be happier with this thing. This thing is enormously beastie. The full draw length is absolutely impressive. The speed coming out of it, considering it's not officially designed, you know, it's just not, you don't have these carbon fiber limbs and all this stuff to actually propel an arrow forward. It's just a pouch. It's a, like a silicone rubber. It's a rubber pouch. And that's awesome. That speaks volumes. So, like I said, thanks guys for watching this. Hope you guys have a great Independence Day at the filming of this video. Should have this up in a week or so. But that'll do it. I'm out. All right, everybody, so we're here at a barbecue. My friend Milano is going to be shooting the pocket shot for you guys. So he's shooting at the same targets.
Film
this part. All right, so this is turned into a hold my beer, let me try moment with the pocket shot.
Hey, hold this.
Right. Oh my God! Right there, ladies and gentlemen, this is the absolute closest miss we've had. Right there, it just nicked the, just the side of it. Grazed it, so hopefully we can actually get this thing to explode. Oh, that was awesome. Let's see where we hit it at. Oh my gosh, this thing just absolutely exploded. Oh, that was so much fun. Well, at least we were able to give you guys a fun explosion. Happy 4th.